Welcome everybody to Redhead Travel Channel. It's already autumn on the West Coast and I just got back from my best whole weekend getaway in Washington State. It was a perfect 3 days road trip with yellow larches of the North Cascades mountains and delicious beer at Oktoberfest in the Bavarian village of Leavenworth. I really enjoyed this trip and I want to share with you my detailed itinerary in this video.
Hold on to the hand of self-destruction. I'm back to a place that I left a long time ago.
The scenic Route 20 North Cascades Highway has been in my plans for a long time, at the very least to drive it. Ideally, I'd love to hike a few trails and stay overnight in a tent. The weather in the fall in the local mountains is not suitable for camping, so we limited ourselves to the viewpoints and a short Blue Lake hike. First, we stopped at the Diablo Lake Vista Point. I really disagree with the name because the view from here looks more like heaven. Diablo Lake is a man-made creation. It was made as a reservoir by Diablo Dam in 1930. We had sandwiches with us. This beautiful lookout was a perfect spot for lunch. Then we hiked Blue Lake Trail. Entrance is $5 in cash on the spot or you can use recreation pass. This trail is fabulously beautiful. It was impossible to look away from the endless variety of fall colors at the top, and the yellow larches were just magical. If it weren't for the terrible cold, I definitely wouldn't have limited myself to 2 hours there. Dress warmly and take thermos with hot tea to enjoy it near the lake. At the end of the day, we stopped at Washington Pass Observation Site. This stretch of the North Cascades Highway is accessible only about half of the year and is covered by up to 40 feet of snow in winter. Leaving behind the stunning mountains of the National Park, we drove into the orange hills of the Okanagan Valley and stayed for the night near Winthrop Town. In the morning we went to explore Winthrop. This charming town makes you feel like you are in an old western movie. At the end of the 20th century, locals came up with the idea to make a Wild West restoration in the town to attract tourists. And it worked out. With a population of under 500 residents, Winthrop welcomes thousands of visitors each year and hosts large-scale festivals like Balloon Roundup, Blues Festival, Wild West Celebration and more. There are lots of cute stores and cafes in town. I highly recommend you don't miss the sour cream bun with mixed berries at Rocking Horse Bakery. Highway 17 took us to an apple heaven. Washington State is the nation's leading apple producer. Its volcanic soil, mild winter, and abundant rain are perfect for growing this fruit. We made a quick stop at the Chief Joseph Dam Powerhouse viewpoint. It's very nice and there are many amenities there. Then the scenery started to look like Iceland. Endless fields with no trees, black earth, empty highway and rocks. We came to Dry Falls land. Dry Falls is a geological wonder of North America. About 1 million years ago, the Great Ice Age began and vast glaciers spread across America. When the climate warmed, about 13,000 years ago, the floods eroded the canyon, forming a huge waterfall, 4 times the size of Niagara. Once the ice sheets melted, the falls desiccated. We decided to go down to the bottom of the canyon and drive around the park. Day pass costs $10. Dry Falls Lake was a disappointment. There was nothing interesting on its shores but tall grass and fishermen. The road to get there was horrible. We turned around and drove to Deep Lake. I liked that lake much better. There were beautiful basalt columns near the parking lot and a great path led to the lake. Some crazy people were jumping off a cliff into the water. We went for a short walk, didn't stay in the park any longer and drove to our next destination. I'm pretty sure you've heard of Leavenworth, a beautiful Bavarian-style village in the Cascade Mountains. Every October on weekends there is a large-scale Oktoberfest celebration with music, dancing, German beer and tons of tourists in traditional costumes. I bought the tickets in advance, but I wasn't expecting this much fun. There were three stages at the festival with giant beer gardens. Musicians and dancers performed, and the fun competitions were held there. I especially like this one, Stein Holding. Honestly, I don't know what was the prize, but all the participants fought desperately to the end. There was a 2-hour waiting list at the local restaurants that night. We were so hungry and tried all the food at the festival. We stayed at Venaccio for the night. We slept well at the hotel, had breakfast in the morning and drove back to Leavenworth. This village is worth a visit not only because of its festival. It was once an ordinary, unremarkable town, but in the early 1960s, the city authorities had a brilliant idea to change Leavenworth's appearance to attract tourists. The magnificent alpine hills were already in place, all that was left was to add Bavarian buildings to the landscape. Now it has a beautiful German-style downtown and more than 2 million visitors from all over the world. There are several pet-friendly restaurants in the village. We went to the München House and ordered their signature Bavarian sausages. They were delicious and with a lot of toppings. Then we stopped in for coffee at the cozy G5 coffee shop. Being a coffee snob, I recommend it. As good as it was at Leavenworth, it was time to go home. We drove along scenic Second Highway and admired the colourful fall mountains. The weather was so nice that we decided to take another short hike along the way, Haybrook Lookout. The parking was limited along the highway, but we managed to find a spot. The trail was pretty steep, but not very hard. We met many families with small children. There was a tall observation tower at the end of the trail. The view from it was quite beautiful and birds were flying around. Please don't feed them. It took us a little over an hour to walk there and back. We grabbed some food at Benjerong Monroe. The portions were gigantic. We passed the border and returned to Vancouver at night. It was a little sad to be back so soon, but it'll be a reason to come back. I hope you enjoyed our little journey. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. Have a great rest of your fall season, and I see you next time. Bye!